Now, with hit songs like True and Gold, Tony Hadley has been entertaining us for 40 years as the frontman of popular 80s band Spandau Ballet. In fact, he's earned himself the accolade of being one of pop's greatest vocalists of all time.
And now the voice behind those chart-topping singles is coming down under for a 40th anniversary tour. And Tony Hadley joins us now live from the UK. Tony, it's such a pleasure to speak to you. What a treat for us.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having us on the show. I want one of those mops.
We'll get one to you.
Everyone wants the floating mop.
That's it.
You can have it.
Tony, 40 years in the music industry. It's such an incredible achievement, from Spandau to 7 solo albums. Could you ever imagine a career as big as the one you've had? Because we couldn't imagine it without you.
To be honest, no. I think when you're a kid, when I was a kid watching Top of the Pops, I mean, you watch your heroes and you think, wow, one day I want to be like that. And then when you actually achieve success, all you do is worry about continuing the success. And now I have to kind of accept that, yeah, I've been pretty successful, 40 years plus. Had a remarkable career, done some amazing things, played some amazing places, met all my heroes over the years. So I kind of think I'm a really lucky boy. Sometimes I have to pinch myself because I'm still that kid who's watching Top of the Pops, you know. I'm very lucky.
Oh, it's so nice to hear. The album True, Tony, launched the band to number one on the UK chart. And we're still listening to your music all these years on. What do you think it is about those songs from Spandau Ballet that still endures all these years later?
Well, the first thing is I didn't think True was a single, so it shows you how much I know about music. But, I think they just connected with people. I mean, if you think about, you know, the early stuff, to cut long story short, and you guys got into us right from the very beginning. But, you know, the difference between to cut long story short and True is quite vast. And so we went to different sort of musical areas as a band and just connected with people. And I don't know what the formula was. There wasn't a formula, but, you know, it just happened.
Did you say that you didn't think True was going to be a single?
No, I'm not sure any of us thought it would. Because up until that point, we'd been a kind of funky synth band kind of thing. And all of a sudden we got True, which is a ballad, you know, and it's a beautiful ballad. But we thought, well, you know, we're not really a ballad band. And it was actually Simon Bates on Radio 1 in England that he got the album, played the single, and he said, if this is not a number one, then there's no justice in the world. Played it again. And, we released it as a single and it went to number one in 21 countries around the world. So, fantastic. Thank God we listened to Simon Bates.
Yeah, it really was. I actually danced the True on Dancing with the Stars in America as well. Oh. But come here, Tony, I have to ask you about Live Aid from 85. Queen, Elton John, Bowie, yourselves. What was that experience like?
Sorry, I just dropped something.
That's all right.
It was kind of incredible. I mean, to be honest, it's like all great events. You don't really... When you're there at the time, you don't appreciate how amazing it actually is. We were so nervous because, you know, this was new technology, satellites, Philadelphia, London, all your heroes backstage. It was one of those once-in-a-lifetime events, and it really was fantastic. And like I say, I mean, I've had many, many great experiences, and Live Aid is pretty much up there, yeah.
Wow, 72,000 people there. 90-odd thousand in Philadelphia. It was on your birthday, actually.
Blows your mind. Yeah. Oh, sweet to remember. Now, the band split in 1990, Tony, and it was great because it gave you a chance to focus on your solo career, but what a big decision to make at the time to step away. Was that a hard one to make?
Well, I didn't split the band, so I was kind of just sort of thinking, what am I going to do? So I know what I'm going to do. I've always loved a bit of rock music. So I thought I'd go to America and go to Los Angeles and I'll make my REO Speed Foreigner album, So West Coast, It's in the Sea. Picked a rock producer, Ron Neverson. And, Yeah, I mean, you know, I made a kind of sort of soft rock album, and it's actually listen. I don't really listen to my old stuff, but occasionally I've listened back and thought, yeah, actually, it's not a bad album. But it wasn't the right album to make. It really wasn't, and I didn't really know what direction I was going in. Now I know exactly where I am. I'm so confident in what I do in terms of songwriting and everything. And we've got a new single, Because of You, which is out, and I'm just a happy boy. I'm happy being happy, and when we do this tour, because I've just literally finished last weekend, 36 dates in the UK.
Wow.
It's a 2-hour show, all the hits, and various surprises along the way. Basically, it's a musical journey, and we've had some fantastic reviews. So I think that's the show we're going to bring to Oz.
Oh, that's yeah. Like you said, you're coming to Oz now as well. You've just done the UK tour as well. Because of COVID, obviously, it must feel completely new to be back on stage now. You must be buzzing for it.
COVID was, I mean, as with everybody around the world, it was one of the, I mean, the weirdest thing is that we're all back to normal, and I've forgotten about COVID. I'm just getting on with the job of enjoying myself and making music. I mean, there's still some people nervous in the audience when we've been playing. There's still some people wearing masks and stuff like that. But generally speaking, back in the UK, everybody is back to normal. We just want to get on with our lives. And so I'm just really, really happy to be playing. The fabulous TH band will be with me. It's going to be rocking. It's going to be great fun. We always have a great time in Australia, always.
Yeah, the audiences get pretty wild down here, I think. We can't wait to have you. Before we let you go, Tony, would you ever consider a reunion tour from you and Spandau Ballet?
I'll do a reunion tour with me. Sorry, that was a really dumb answer, really, wasn't it? No, unfortunately not. I mean, it just went too far. It really did go too far. Not of my making, I might add. It wasn't me that did it. The guys, hopefully one day, will give you a very honest answer as to why they hacked off their lead singer to such an extent that he left the band. And I feel sorry for the fans, because it shouldn't have happened. But unfortunately, it did. So, do you know, I'm just happy, as I said before, just happy being happy.
Yeah.
And I just want to get on with my life. And I wish them all the best.
Yeah.
You know, there's no animosity there. They're getting on with their lives, and I'm getting on with mine.
It's great to hear. We'll always have the memories, and we get to see you now coming down under again, which is fantastic.
Our arms are wide open, ready to welcome you home to Australia. For more information on Tony's tour dates, you can visit the website on your screen now. Tony, we're so pumped to have you here. Thank you for taking the time to talk to us today.
Thank you. You're an absolute legend. Honestly, we cannot wait. We're very, very excited. Trust me, we really are.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Can't wait to see you here. Take care, mate.